Hey, my name is Dylan, and these are some tips and tricks to help you blow through your YouTube videos even faster. The first one you may do already, and if that's the case, let me know in the comments. If you find you're using the same titles, the same templates, the same elements and sound effects in pretty much all of your videos, and you get annoyed at how you have to find them, bring them onto your timeline, and adjust them the way you like every single new video, instead, just do this. Create a new library. Maybe label it YouTube Video Template. Create a new project. Hit the keyboard shortcut Option W to make a really long gap clip. And when you're editing your next YouTube video and you just customize your title the way you want and you added sound effects at a specific volume at the right time, hold Command and select everything. Press Command C to copy. Switch to that Final Cut template project that you just created and press Command V to paste. What you'll be doing is creating a library that you can access every time you make YouTube videos so you can quickly copy those customized elements and paste them into the new video without having to adjust them every single time. This may seem obvious, but trust me when I say this has saved me arguably the most time when it comes to creating my YouTube videos. As an example, I have all of my pop-ups set with modified drop zones, text the way I like it, and the big one is adjusted sound effects positioned at the right time underneath. I even have sound effects that I use often for transitions and stuff, all adjusted to be the right volume. I have my backgrounds in here and my call to actions. Then, like I mentioned, you could even just hold Command and just drag a selection of entire areas of media, then press Command C and paste that by pressing Command V into your new YouTube video. Let's move on to tip number two to talk about what I'll call minute adjustments. So for example, after you paste these clips into your new video, maybe you feel they're not playing at the right time in the video. Maybe they need to be a couple frames over, you think. With them selected, just hit comma a few times to nudge everything to the left a few frames, and hit period to nudge to the right a few frames. If you really missed the spot that you needed to paste the elements, you can hold shift and hit comma or period, and it'll nudge it 10 frames. You can also do this with clips. If this clip is a little long and you'd like it to cut a few frames earlier, just select the end of the clip and press comma a few times. And pressing period will extend the end of that clip a frame. I also find this extremely useful when it comes to adding sound effects. I'll isolate my sound effect by pressing Option S. You can also just go and press the solo select button over here. And then I'll press period or comma to make sure the sound effect is in the exact spot that it needs to be to match the visuals of the transition. Another minute adjustment that helps a lot, instead of having to drag down volume of music, sound effects, or dialogue, just select the clip and press Control minus or Control plus a few times. This raises or lowers your volume by a single decibel. Tip number three, if you're someone who adds these same LUTs, effects, color grades, even audio effects to your clips, every time you make a new YouTube video, stop making these adjustments every single time you edit. Instead, just make them once, hit this button down here, Save Effects Preset, type in what name you'd like to give it. For this, we'll say YouTube Studio Grade and Effects. Maybe put it in the Custom category and hit Save. Now, when you start a new YouTube video, don't go through that tedious process of adding everything and adjusting them again. Just go to your effects browser, head to Custom, and select that preset that you made earlier. Easy work. It's the same with audio. Once you have all of your adjustments made, hit Save Effects Preset, and go through the same process. Then, when the time comes, head down to the Custom section in your audio and select that preset. You can speed up your editing even more by doing this. Control right-click that audio effect and select Make Default Audio Effect. And do the same thing with the video one. Then, the next time you start a YouTube video and you want to add all of that sauce to your video, you don't even have to go into this browser. Just select the clip and hit Option E. Think Option Effect, and that effects preset with all of your adjustments will be added. And for the audio preset, just hit Option Command E. So once again, that was Option E for the effects and Option Command E for the audio effects. Tip number four to creating YouTube videos faster is to utilize one of the best things about Final Cut Pro, and that is the way you're able to organize your footage. I'm not gonna dive too heavily in on the subject, but you may or may not already know that you can select your clip or sections of your clip and press the F key to favor which parts of your clips you like. Then you can head to this drop-down menu, go to Favorites, and see all the best bits of your footage to help make editing an easier time for you. And by the way, to see what parts of your clips you've used in your project, go to View, Browser, and click Used Media Ranges. These orange bars will show up to show you what you've used. Another thing that is immensely helpful, especially when you have a boatload of footage, is to use keywords. Keywords are like sticky notes for your footage. So you'll select the clip or section of the clip and hit Command K. This brings up your keyword shortcut editor. Think of this as your sticky note pad. Type in some words to help you identify this clip later. Then when you get to similar clips, use the same words. That way, when you're in the middle of editing your video and you think, I wonder what parts of clips I have with an animal looking at the camera, you can just expand your event, click that keyword, and you have everything you need right there. The last tip I have for you to create YouTube videos faster is to use plugins. And don't click off just yet, because I'll go over two paid ones and one that is free that'll help you a ton. You probably already know what a plugin is, but if you don't, they're basically special tools that you can add to Final Cut that can help you make your videos look even better in a shorter amount of time. Two that I use constantly are MTuber 2 and MTuber 3 from Motion VFX. They are specifically made for YouTubers, and there's quite a lot of presets in them. Each pack has different types of call to actions, intros, pop-up tools, text, and even transitions that you can use. Using these presets make it so you don't have to create your own in Apple Motion or create some janky looking ones in Final Cut. I highly recommend them, and I will put a link to them in the description. There's also a free plugin that I use in every single video, and I've made a video about it before. It's called Tap 5A, and it is a drag and drop in and out animation plugin. So if you want a picture to animate into your shot a certain way, you can quickly make those adjustments with pretty much the click of a button. And there's tons of options for how it animates in and out. And then you can just do the same thing if you want it to animate out a certain way. It's easy to use, and the best part is, it's free. I'll leave a link to this one in the description as well. Also, how much do you know about the range tool in Final Cut? If you're wanting to learn some cool and helpful tricks in a short 3-minute video, click this video right here and have a great rest of your day, guys.